Now, where does one go to escape the realities of life? That I don't know, but what I know is that we're not here to help you escape those realities. We're here to return you to them. Hi, I am Camille, your presenter on this evening's program. On Exposé, our segment which features young talent throughout St. Vincent and the Grenadines, Sheridan would be speaking with a lady who organized and created a group of young talented ladies here in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And this segment comes with the kind compliments of Bottlers St. Vincent Limited.
I'm Sheridan and welcome to Exposé. Earlier this year, you've been hearing about a very talented group, the Caribee Starz, of which I'm a member. With me, I have the leader and trainer of the group, Mrs. Edith Dougherty. Welcome to Exposé.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm very happy to say that I'm a resident of Bekwe. I love living in Bekwe. My husband and I have lived there for about a year, and I enjoy St. Vincent and the Grenadines, and I especially enjoy the Caribee Starz. Yeah.
What are the objectives of the group?
Well, initially the objectives were to give individual vocal singing training to the members, and we did a first session in April under the auspices of the Minister of Culture and Education, and that went so well that, as you know, Sheridan, we wanted to keep going. So our objective continues to be my individual training of all the Caribee Starz. And also, because we're evolving into such a wonderful group, also to do shows in which we have an opportunity to show off not only the individual skills, but also the group singing together. We're also very strong about being a cultural holder of songs of St. Vincent. We're going to be doing more research into the songs of St. Vincent in the area. So part of our mission is to keep the beautiful culture through its music and storytelling alive.
Do you care to highlight the activities the group was involved in since its inception?
Sure. In April, we did a workshop for some of the teachers in the area, in which all of the students sang a solo, and I had a lot of fun coaching you all in the singing. And then we began in the summer to work on a concert August 2nd, which was very exciting. We were very fortunate to have the Governor General and Lady Antrobus there, and Prime Minister Mitchell, and just a lot of wonderful people in our audience. So we are now focusing on two events. One is December 5th, we're singing for the Soroptimists, and then December 20th, we're doing a concert in St. Vincent at the Squash Complex, and Sunday, December 21st, at in Beckway, my digs. I think I said it wrong. It's Friday, December 19th at the Squash Complex, yes.
What has been the cooperation like among group members and the public as a whole?
Well, I'm very pleased to say that you all are now coming on time, which for me as a North American, although I now consider myself a Caribbean person, for me to work with people who sort of dribble in within a half an hour or an hour of when I call a rehearsal, that has been a big challenge. However, all the group members have begun to realize that our time together is very precious. So one of my greatest thrills is that everyone now comes on time, so we're really able to do a lot.
Has the group been meeting your expectation?
Absolutely. And the great thing for me as trainer and teacher of the group is that my expectations get higher and higher as you meet my expectations. I'm, for example, right now we're working on a four-part harmony composition which I wrote. And can you imagine when I first began working with you in April, if I had given you the Dawn Alleluia, the four-part composition, I think you all would have walked out. What is this lady trying to do? So, yes, this training session, I'm very pleased to have my expectations rising and to have them fulfilled, too. Thanks.
To conclude, what would you tell our viewers to expect from Caribee Starz?
Oh, the best, and a lot of fun, and a good sound, individually and collectively. Plus, we do a lot of good dancing to our songs. So, to expect the best, because you are the best of the best.
Thank you, Mrs. Dougherty. I'm Sheridan. See you next week on Exposé.
Time to enter in. Pepsi. Generation Next.
This evening, our Black History segment features the life and times of a great African leader, his struggle against apartheid, and the long martyrdom of his 27 years in prison. We remember Nelson Mandela.
It was here, in the Transkei territory, that he was born, on July 18, 1918. Blacks had been forced to these territories after the ruling white government passed the Native Land Act in 1913. The act forbid black ownership of land, or sharecropping, or tenant farming anywhere but in these so-called African reserves. These restrictions only foreshadowed the more sweeping doctrine of apartheid to come. Mandela was born into the royalty of the Tembu tribe, and Nelson, like his father, was being groomed to become a chief. But during his education at the Methodist Mission Center in Helltown, and later at Fort Hare University College, he decided to pursue a career in law. Activism came early to Nelson Mandela. Participation in a student strike resulted in him being thrown out of Fort Hare at the age of 22. But 2 years later, he did receive his degree. And 2 years after that, in 1944, he joined the African National Congress. Having moved to Johannesburg, Mandela, together with Oliver Tambo and Walter Sisulu, founded the Congress Youth League of the ANC. In those early years, Mandela was an organizer and a leader, a believer in protest, but also in nonviolence.
I have fought against white domination, and I have fought against black domination. I have cherished the ideal of a democratic and free society in which all persons live together in harmony and with equal opportunities. It is an ideal which I hope to live for and to achieve. But if needs be, it is an ideal for which I am prepared to die.
After an 11-month trial, Nelson Mandela was sentenced to life in prison.
Mandela way to Sunda, Mandela way to Sunda, Mandela way to Sunda, Mandela way to Sunda, Duma Sabusha, Duma Sabusha.
Let each one of you and all of our people give the enemies of peace and liberty no space to take us back to the dark hell of apartheid.
Free man, no longer just a series of still pictures and fragments from decades-old speeches. He is a man with a plan for his country and his people. He's a man now out of prison with whom his allies and enemies must deal.
Thank you.
Been described as a special effect movie event of the year, Spawn, when a government assassin played by Todd McFarlane requests his release. He was offered one last job, and that's exactly what it was, for his fellow comrades became his assassins.
Just get me to a hospital.
A hospital? Have you looked in the mirror lately, Birdman walking? Even the entire cast of ER couldn't put you back together again. How do I put this to you? You're pushing up daisies, you're in permanent nap time. Your fertilizer, hey, is any of this sinking in? You're dead.
D.
Dead. I guess 5 years feeding earthworms is even what little brain there was in there.
What are you?
But allow me to kickstart your memory. Hang on. These flashbacks can be killers.
You are the dead man.
See you in hell, Al.
Oh,
Destined to revenge and save his soul, he made a deal with the devil so as to return and destroy those who murdered him. Spawn is available at Videos About Hung. Now it's time for this evening's quiz. Name the actor who played the role of Malcolm X in Spike Lee's version of the true story depicting the life and death of Malcolm X. That is, name the actor who played the role of Malcolm X in Spike Lee's version of the true story depicting the life and death of Malcolm X. The winner would receive 1 week of free rentals, compliments, Videos About Hung. So you could send your entries to any of their branches or in care of Video Showcase, P.O. Box 1375. And for those of you who were wondering why I did not mention the winner for last week's quiz question, that will be coming up at the end of this evening's program. Now, the superhero volcano of Montserrat is still very active and fair of a major eruption at any time. This week, we focus on one of Mother Nature's most deadly elements, volcanoes. This week, we focus on one of Mother Nature's deadly fury, volcano. From seething cauldrons deep within the earth, magma or molten rock emerges like an incandescent tide. It sails its way across the landscape or explodes into Vulcan red-hot lava, piercing the earth mantle like a blowtorch at temperatures that exceed 200 degrees Fahrenheit. Volcanoes are among the most dramatic spectacles on Earth and the most deadly. Throughout history, they have burned whole cities, killed hundreds of thousands of people, and darkened the skies with lethal gases. Most people assume that lava is the most dangerous discharge from a volcano, but historically, there are far more deadly ejectors, including hot mud, ashes, and deadly gases, which are responsible for 75% more death during an eruption. The superheated black cloud of gas and ashes kills thousands in minutes and is called pyroclastic flow. One example was among Pile in Martinique in 1902, where pyroclastic flow killed 32,000 and leave only two survivors. The longer a volcano lies dormant, the more violent the eruption. Eruptions can be so intense that they create thunderheads. A single volcano can erupt over and over once active. Mount Pinatubo in the Philippines erupted 62 times in June 1991. Although the word volcano comes from Vulcan, the Roman god of destructive fire, volcanoes can also have a beneficial side. Volcanic ash are remarkable potent fertilizers, and when heated by magma, produce electric powers in New Zealand and heat homes in Iceland. Underestimate, there are 1,500 active volcanoes in the world. The Lassifera Hills volcano of Montserrat is among them. The fact that the entire island of Montserrat is a volcano didn't trouble the residents. People like Oliver Mayada benefit from the rich volcanic soil and tourist economy.
We always live in Webbs. I built a nice little house there, and I was doing well until after this volcano been getting busy, you know.
Fortunes changed in 1995.
We're sleeping, right? And this rumble wake us. This thing blow. And then we get up, me and my family then get up and went outside. When we look at the mountain, and the whole place was dark, lightning, all kind of spark lightning and so forth, flashing. When I said, this is it, we're going to die this time, man. My family began to cry. I have to tell them, cool it, take it easy. If I say I wasn't scared, I'm lying. I was shaking.
And the days that follows, pyroclastic clouds proof from the mountain. Oliver's family and half the island's population are evacuated. The effect of a burning cloud can be seen on a dwelling that stood in its path. And the farmlands are ruined and tourists are scared away.
felt we're going to pick up some more clothing and so forth. There's six of us in this little room here. Four kids and myself and my wife. We don't even have a bathroom. Right? We have to fill water in pails and go to the back and have a little shower in pail, which is real rough.
Periodic eruptions follow the original blast up to today, sending ash clouds down to island slopes. Scientists fear that this might go on throughout Oliver's life. The Mayada family may never go home again. St. Vincent's own La Soufriere last erupted in 1979, causing mass evacuation from the areas which surrounds the crater. Volcanoes are one of the most destructive natural forces in the world, and at some times they are one of nature's most fascinating displays. Lakes of fire, holes in the earth, a sulfuric odor that fills the air, a description that brings to mind the depths of hell.
Perfect selection, Spectron, St. Vincent and the Grenadines' number one wedding video producers. Now you can have your wedding professionally videotaped in fine movie style with the latest Hollywood effects, along with love music to suit your taste. If you wish, you can have your wedding videotaped without defects in regular style. We provide a second copy absolutely free. That perfect wedding deserves a perfect video. So choose Spectron, the perfect selection. Located upstairs, Reliance Pretree. You can call anytime at telephone number 457-2864.
The Daily Herald is SVG's only daily newspaper accessible throughout the country. The Herald's content spans the gamut from local and regional news to international business, politics and sports, along with entertaining features, TV listings, lottery and 3D results. With a dedicated team of professionals, we're doing our part to develop SVG, be up to date with information. We're also on the internet and we make advertising easy. Read the Herald daily, SVG's only daily newspaper, and step with us into the 21st century.
Good evening. I am Curtis with our movie line. It's time for that lucky person to name the movie or star of this popular movie line. That lucky person will receive $50, compliments, videos about town. So, send your entries to any of their branches, or in care of Video Showcase, PO Box 1375. Remember to stay tuned for last week's movie line winner, coming up at the end of the program.
A slew of gigantic top titles are heading your way, and they're already available at Videos About Town. Now here's a peek of some of the top movies, guaranteed to be among the best here in St. Vincent and the Grenadines.
Videos About Town.
Videos About Town.
Videos About Town.
Videos
About Town.
Of the Weez.
Of the Weez.
Of the Weez.
Of the Weez.
Yeah.
You.
You don't recognize your own handiwork.
Hey, Sam, isn't this Jake Metzner's old scarf?
Marla, don't touch that.
What's the problem, Sam? It's just a scarf.
Mother of God.
Nah, bitch couldn't make it.
Thought you said conventional weapons couldn't touch that thing.
Now look what you've got and done.
It's hot.
Made in America.
Get out of the way, what are you, nuts? Get
number 7.
Is it possible that it didn't happen? Yes. As a scientist, I must concede that. I must volunteer that.
Wait a minute, let me get this straight. You admit that you have absolutely no physical evidence to back up your story.
Yes.
You admit that you very well may have hallucinated this whole thing.
Yes.
You admit that if you were in our position, you would respond with exactly the same degree of incredulity and skepticism.
Yes.
Then why don't you simply withdraw your testimony and concede that this journey to the center of the galaxy, in fact, never took place?
Because I can't.
Number two.
I realize this comes at a very inopportune time. Marry me.
The moment I wake up, before you put on your makeup.
TriStar Pictures presents.
I'm the bad guy.
A story about finding the love of your life.
Do you really love him?
And deciding.
Or is this just about winning?
What to do about it?
I trusted you. Just tell me what.
Why did you trust me?
No, why did you pretend to be my friend?
Julia Roberts.
Oh.
Dermot Mulroney and Cameron Diaz.
Lovely together.
My best friend's wedding.
Michael!
That's our maid of honor.
Thank you.
say otherwise. We say clip, clip, clip. We're new and fresh and more gentle. We are meticulous with what we do. That's why we call ourselves professionals. It's Professional Barber Salon, conveniently located next to Videos About Town, Honors Vale. Presently, there is a special and all haircuts. Check this out. Children, $3. Adults, $7. And, you guessed it, the children get to play video games free at the arcade while they wait. Professional Barber Salon boosts two professional and classy barbers. For appointment, call 456-5740. You'll see the difference with the fabulous haircuts from Professional Barber Salon at Honors Vale.
We are down to the end of this evening's program, but here's letting you know that one of the most noted elements of Video Showcase is our variety, which plays a significant role in the way in which we extend our hospitality to you, our many viewers. Now, before we go, like as we promised, here's the winner for our quiz and movie line. That's last week's quiz and movie line. Our quiz winner is Desiree Jones of Cane Garden, and she answered the question, name the actress who starred in the 1950s classic, The Nun Story, that person, Audrey Hepburn. Now, our movie line winner, Rennie Durant of Annisville, that line was, put the bunny back in the box, and it was said by Nicolas Cage in the movie Con Air. Now I have two short letters here from 12 of our fans. This one is from Colette John of Barley. She wrote, I very much enjoy your show. Keep up the good work. Continue to keep the faith and love for the public because we love you. This one is from Pauline Austin of Queen Drive. She wrote, there, that video showcase. Your program is very educational and informative. Please keep up the good work. So now on behalf of all of us here at Video Showcase, Curtis and Morales, I am Camille saying do have a pleasant evening and I'm looking forward to your company next Wednesday.
Illiteracy is man's greatest enemy. So it's your duty, yes, your duty, stamp it out completely. Ignorance always impede progress. Education saves you much distress. Learn, 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 learn as much as you can. This nation's future is in your hands. Children go to school and learn well. Otherwise, later on in life, you're gonna catch real hell. Without an education in your head, your whole life will be pure misery. You're better off dead, I mean dead, dead. For there is simply no room in this whole wide world for an uneducated little boy or girl. Don't allow idle companions to lead you astray. To earn tomorrow, you got to learn.